the message coming from a predominantly white league has a lot bigger impact. Not bigger impact, but it has a very strong impact when it's coming from players like this. You know, most of these guys have never lived through some of the stuff that black athletes have. You know, they don't go through those day-to-day things that they feel that racism, or they've seen the racism, or their family's gone through it. But for them to say, look, we see what's going on in society, and we disagree with it, and something has to change right now. That was my message, and I think I said that standing together here is more powerful than anything you can do. We're in a bubble. There's nothing you can do outside the bubble right now, and we can't change anything because we're stuck in here. But together in here right now, that's what we can do.
We just all thought it was the best course of action, and you know, everything that Brian's has been saying, you know, that we need to come together, and obviously this stuff, kind of stuff, can't stand, and that we need to educate ourselves and realize what's going on in the world. And you know, I think he's hit the nail right on the head that, you know, there needs to be change, and you know, us being all together here, you know, as one, definitely shows you know, strength in the hockey community as well as you know, in the world.
Well, you know, we obviously had a chance to talk as a team last night, and you know, I think this morning it went beyond that, and we all got together as players to try to figure out, you know, what sort of direction we were going to be going in here. We got to speak with some of the players in the bubble in Edmonton, and you know, when we realized that they were, you know, Vancouver and Vegas, I think we're considering sitting out tonight, and got to speak with them and speak with Ryan Reaves and talk about obviously the issue at hand and how important this is. You know, I think it was something that we were all fully behind, and obviously with what transpired yesterday and the other leagues sitting out, you know, I think we felt that we took our time and were able to process this as a whole and speak as a group of players and make the right decision. And, you know, today I think unified us as a group to realize that any black player in this league, any black player who's a kid coming up playing hockey, can feel like that they have a voice, can feel like that the NHL and the sport itself is a safe place, and a place that, you know, obviously in a predominantly white sport, they feel alienated, but they have the support of every single one of us. And that's what we're striving to achieve here is inclusion and making sure that everyone feels welcome in the sport of hockey.
You know, we came to understand and to really have that opportunity to support, you know, our fellow black players in this league, and they weren't comfortable playing. We were right behind them. And I think, you know, that inclusion, that support, that we have for them is, you know, extremely important. And there's a lot of stuff that, you know, I don't have the answers to moving forward, but it's a conversation. It's these times to reflect, that we need to have as a group, as, you know, not just in the hockey community, but outside of that as well. And, you know, I think, you know, continuing to do our best to make a difference is what we have to continue to do moving forward. And there's not a lot there. It doesn't sound like that, but the answers are out there, and hopefully we can find them.
Yeah, you know, I think the best thing that happened, you know, last night I struggled with, you know, what I wanted to do, whether it was, you know, am I really going to walk out on my team and be the only guy, or is there going to be a couple guys? But I woke up to, you know, a text from Kevin Shattenkirk, and he had a bunch of guys out east there, and they wanted to talk, and then I got a text saying Vancouver wanted to talk, and, you know, that I think was more powerful, that it started, the conversation started with white players on other teams wanting to talk, and, you know, I think that's the most powerful thing that happened today. And now you see us all coming together, all opponents here. You know, I hope after this, you know, I don't expect every one of these guys to go out and, you know, be advocates for this movement, but I'm sure a lot of us are, and that's the biggest thing. You can't just talk about it in the bubble and then go home and live your life. You gotta start being part of it, and I expect lots of us to.